印度自拍风潮兴盛，热门景点都不乏游客挤眉弄眼自拍打卡。但是印度同时也是自拍意外死亡件数最高的国家。2011年到2017年就发生了159件自拍死亡事故。民间现在推出了危险地标提醒软体，政府也在特定的地点设置禁止自拍区来取缔，为的就是不要再增加无谓的伤亡人口。
这里是印度新德里最高的桥梁，由于造型独特，常吸引自拍网美前来朝圣，每天都有几十人慕名而来，为自己瞧好最棒的角度，完全无视一旁的混乱交通。
Yes, it's dangerous. Sometimes you just don't notice the cars around you. You have to be careful.
We would do anything to take a good selfie.
近年印度人疯极限自拍，为了捕捉精彩瞬间，却屡屡传出酿成永远的遗憾。像是这张照片中，一群学生挑战极限自拍，调皮的将半身悬在峭壁下，想不到其中一人不慎失足丧命。而这名男子呢，则是想和经过的火车自拍，却没有抓准距离，直接遭列车迎头撞上，身受重伤。事实上，印度的自拍事故次数名列世界第一。2011到2017年就发生159件自拍死亡事故。皮杰在学生时期就曾跟朋友忙于自拍，差点溺水身亡。于是他着手开发应用程式，提醒用户潜在的危险地点。
Selfies are a really great way of capturing your memories, but when we get carried away too much and when you try to not bother about your surroundings and you know when you just keep clicking selfies when you get addicted to it, it becomes a problem.
沉迷自拍已成为印度举国关注的议题。有心理医师认为，这已经是攸关精神健康的问题。
The intention is to be out there, be daring. The riskier I become, the more entertainment it's going to create for my social media platform. Selfies that way have also become a lot of, have become an extension of addictions.
印度政府也祭出措施，呼吁民众自拍时小心周遭环境，像是在特定区域设置禁止自拍区，派出救生员严加执法。
Before there happened lots of incidents of spine injury, fractures, but now we are taking special care for with the signboards and the flags.
违反规定的民众将被开罚最高500多台币的罚款，但比起罚款，更重要的是，没有任何自拍照值得用生命去换。记者林孝如报道。